Hello and welcome to another special Unsourced representation. Now you might recall that during my last video I talked about my thoughts on the previous MCU Spider-Man movies in preparation for the premiere of No Way Home, and how one thing that was very odd about them was that they basically don't work as entries in a series. How Homecoming is basically a spin-off to the Iron Man trilogy, and that Far From Home is kind of a self-reboot, ignoring and actively backtracking stuff from Homecoming. But with how that film ended, and how No Way Home has been promoted as a direct continuation and a proper sequel, would it shock you for me to say that Marvel has kind of done the same thing yet again? Listen, making a trilogy is hard, especially in a large franchise. Even something as small as Roger Corman's Death Race film franchise has a trilogy that consists entirely of remakes of itself. And even the most consistent trilogy thus far in the MCU, the Iron Man trilogy, had its fair share of flaws. So it's unfair to expect a perfect narrative through line that carries forth within a set of three movies with constraints like this. That said, this is insane. Let's get the good stuff out of the way first. I think that as with Far From Home, supporting cast has more leeway with runtime. MJ and Ned feeling more at home as Peter's emotional bond and support system than they've been given license to be in the previous two movies. And just to get out of the way, the fan service is pretty good. Not very well integrated and unevenly handled, but the film is at least a bit more creative and funny than I was expecting with how it creates set pieces using the three film universes at its disposal. I got a good amount of laughs and chuckles when those moments popped up, and I'm not ashamed to say it. That said, that's really where my fondness for the film starts to fade. Story-wise and in terms of narrative purpose, the film doesn't actually really have one. If Far From Home and Homecoming worked at cross purposes, then No Way Home is the flimsy tape trying to keep them intact. What I mean by that is that much of the MCU side of things of the film is heavily focused on redressing all three of the MCU Spider-Man movies as being part of one singular origin story. That this is finally the true beginning moment for Peter becoming Spider-Man. Which, you know, is kind of weird given that it's the final film in a whole trilogy and Peter's sixth film appearance in MCU overall. So a lot of what it tries to do to set up this perspective for itself in the other two movies feels both unearned and very artificial. When Homecoming came out, it had a bit of praise for being this new vision for Spider-Man that didn't concern itself retreading old pieces of the lore that we'd already seen twice before already in two different movies. So it dived headfirst and started doing new things, etc., etc. So six movies in, and now we're having this entire movie whose whole motivation seems to be to quickly rush through those old pieces of lore that is awkward and nonsensical at times. I.e., it gives every movie this feeling of, well, Marvel not knowing what the hell they're doing and just throwing things at the wall to see what sticks. Should this one be really connected to Iron Man? Should this one be a solo adventure tangentially connected to larger MCU stuff? Or should this one be where we wipe the slate clean and start from scratch? The MCU Spider-Man trilogy feels like a game of round robin, where instead of being a product of a large multimedia franchise spanning over two dozen films and associated TV series at this point, it's like each one was going in at it blind. It's an incompetence that shouldn't be warranted and honestly makes something like The Amazing Spider-Man 2 feel more thought out and meticulously planned. All that said, it's not the worst of the three. I still rank Homecoming worse for its tedium and heavy ties to stuff that didn't really need to be included. But No Way Home is still lesser to Far From Home. The fan service is fun, as I've said, and if there's stuff you've been waiting years to see, it's most likely in here. It's just not enough to really buffer a story that's not even meant to be a story. Just status quo setting to springboard new films from. And that's a shame. Overall, I'd give it a 6 out of 10. It's not unwatchable, there's a lot of fun stuff in it, but it's nothing you should go out of your way to see. It's kind of run-of-the-mill. Now, I have something really spoiler-heavy to talk about. So if you don't want to hear spoilers, then this is the time to end it. But if you do, please just follow me here, because if I don't talk about it and someone else does, I'm going to regret it forever. But yeah, No Way Home is an origin story, and they make this excessively clear by having Aunt May die. Peter feel like it's his fault, and having Aunt May be the one who gives him the "with great responsibility" line, which is made explicit that this is the first time he's heard it. And the other Spider-Man emphasize that this means that this is his first transition to becoming Spider-Man for real. Which I believe means that Uncle Ben is still alive. I'm 99.99999% sure of it. Let me run down my theory here. 1. Only Toby and Andrew bond over Uncle Ben's death. Peter doesn't, and his only reference point in the scene where the bonding is happening is Aunt May's death. And, of course, the shared responsibility line, even though they come from two sources. 2. The only time that people have ever really pointed to as a reference to Uncle Ben in this MCU trilogy as ever having existed is in Homecoming, when Peter mentions that Aunt May has gone through a lot lately. That could have easily been a divorce. Maybe her and Uncle Ben didn't just work out. That would also explain why she seems to be more on the prowl dating-wise throughout these movies. 3. If he was dead, they would have bonded over him. Like, that's such a no-brainer to have these three Spider-Men bond over Uncle Ben that it seems insane that they wouldn't have done it if they could have. And if Aunt May is going to be his version of Uncle Ben, like that above-mentioned scene really underlines and highlights, then it makes sense for the real Uncle Ben to still be alive, because otherwise that's just a huge wasted opportunity. So yeah, if that happens, I gotta buy a lottery ticket. We already know there's gonna be a second trilogy, so if Uncle Ben is still alive, which I'm pretty sure he is, then it'd be cool to see him there. It just seems that there have been ideas spread throughout these three movies that could have been avoided and could have been a lot better utilized if all these were made into one single film. It seems like Marvel didn't want to make an origin movie to begin with, but then immediately regretted it, and so they kind of had to go this convoluted way to work their way through back to a sufficient starting point. But did it really need like 6 films to get to this point? And I gotta say no. And overall, No Way Home is this purpose-built film meant solely to create that groundwork and setting. 6 out of 10. There's fun stuff in it, but honestly not that much that's engaging, unless you want things to be big puzzle pieces rather than emotionally investing and character driven stories, and this isn't. See you again next time. Hope you have a great weekend, hope you have a great holiday season, and be safe out there.